The Nairobi National Museum is an amazing place if you're here to check out the exhibits, but I want to get a deeper look into artifacts. Sure, it's nice and tidy to see them on display, but every museum anywhere in the world has an area that stores ancient objects. Here at our museum in Nairobi, it's called the Cultural Heritage Center, a place with so much more history than any strategically laid out display on a museum floor. You know, the history actually speaks to you here when you're in this storage room for the museum. It's so different than being in the exhibition hall because I guess this is where everything comes before it actually makes its way to where you go when you come on tour of the museum. Now, for instance, you've got these musical instruments used by the old families, I guess, to tell stories and sing songs. I'm not a musician, so we'll leave that one, to a standard functional axe. Now, if you look at this, not a heck of a lot has changed in terms of functionality when you come to an axe. This is from 1906. And again, you can see yourself chopping some wood with this one as well. This is one of my favorite items that I've seen. This is called a quiver. Now, this is a really fancy little gadget, little lid on top. And here you find, let me grab one that's loose here, you find the arrows for the bow and arrows used by many tribes here today and from the 18 and 1900s for hunting and for war as well, which is such a cool, I love this thing, it's such a cool little device. And then if you move over here, you've got traditional spearheads. We know that many of our tribes in Kenya use these, and you know, you can just see the kind of war style that they go on. Okay, I'm not supposed to be clowning around, so let me put these down and let's continue our journey to find out more about the origins of Swahili furniture. Now this is the main man, Ray Balongo, and no one knows more about the origins of furniture from this region than Ray. And we're about to find out just how much he does know. Hi, Ray.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good, thank you. And you?
Welcome.
Good, good, good. I've just had a bit of a look around this whole area here.
Yeah.
And this is basically the store area before things actually make it
exactly,
to the museum.
Yeah.
How does that all
work? These are the objects from the field. Once they come here,
right,
we do the documentation, prepare them, we store them for posterity. Then whenever the exhibition comes up or we plan about the exhibition, mm-hmm, we come up, select the ones that we want to use for the exhibition, then take them out for the
right
exhibit.
Now, I'm on this sort of mission and journey to find out more about chairs and stools and the origins of what we sit on here in Kenya, and I see you've
absolutely
got...
Absolutely. As you look here, we have objects from different, mm-hmm, or stools from different communities ready to be taken for an
right
exhibition. Now, for example, this one, this is a stool from Western Kenya,
right,
from a community called Tiriki. You might think that actually these are just decorations, mm-hmm, but each decoration has a sign and it has
a
purpose and it has a story on it.
Does this also tell a story? Because to me it kind of just looks like some triangles or tents or something.
Actually, this is showing the shapes of the moon. It's used by the old man in a community. Well, this shows that actually the old man is a polygamist, whereby the shape of the moon will tell in which house the owner is going to sleep in.
So are all of these the wives, or is because he's a very lucky man, because I can count almost 30 there.
These are not all the wives. These shapes shows that actually if you are going to meet the wife on this side, the four shapes or the three shapes will tell you that you are supposed to be going into this house.
This is like a lunar calendar for like a reproductive
exactly
cycle.
Exactly, that's it.
What about this piece here? I mean, you're talking about a number of different stools. Is this also a stool?
This is also a stool. And this one is from the Turkana people.
Right. So this is a stool?
This is a stool. It's used by the male. The old man uses this one while going to hunt, while going to...
This is like a portable chair slash pillow.
Yes. This being a portable chair, when he goes out and he's tired, he will sit on it. When he's resting on his head, he puts it under his head, just like this.
And just lies on the ground.
Yes, so that he's able to see what's happening, not to put the head direct on the ground.
It's like a soldier's pillow.
Exactly.
Yeah. This is brilliant. Thank you, Ray.
Yeah.
Excellent. I guess the one thing we can take away from all this is that no matter where you're from, anywhere in the world, furniture is still viewed as some sort of status symbol. Okay, it's morphed over the years to take on different roles and importance in people's lives, but at the end of the day, it really is about comfort and functionality. And it's been that way for centuries. Well, it's been a great day learning about the origins of furniture from this part of Africa. But like anyone who absorbs so much, I just found myself a little bit tired. So I found the shade of a tree and the perfect place to rest my head. And I'll see you some other time.